Most breaches occur when someone has given open access to their account by basically leaving the back door open if you've only got it protected with an email address and a password. What are the best workplace security tips for SMEs? That's a wonderful question. I'll give you a few off the top of my head now. Number one for small businesses to implement is a two-factor authentication policy. Make sure you switch that on. Two-factor authentication is enabled on many accounts when you log into Google for the first time. But for most businesses that we work with, it's not enabled as a policy inside of Google Workspace. So you may have some staff that have not set up a second factor of authentication. You can also ensure there that your team have strong passwords, and there's a number of other security features included in there as well. Most breaches occur when someone has given open access to their account by basically leaving the back door open if you've only got it protected with an email address and a password. We're all guilty of reusing passwords unless you've rolled out something like LastPass. And for many people, the password they use for their email is something memorable, so therefore you're going to use it for other websites as well. And so what happens is, if one other website that you have used becomes compromised, someone gets access to your email address and your password combination, boom, they're into your account. And if you're a business owner, that means they have access to your whole business. And so setting that is absolutely number one, and making sure that it's a policy enforced right across your whole company. So to do that, you go to your admin panel, admin.google.com, you go to your security settings and implement a forced two-factor authentication policy. What we've also seen in the last few years, unfortunately, is many people are actually having mobile phone numbers hijacked. If someone somehow gets access to your identity, and there have been many high-profile cases of security breaches in organizations that have leaked the personal identity of consumers, especially here in Australia, we've had a number in the last couple of months. Once someone has your identity, they can actually call your phone provider, pretend to be you, and actually switch your number to a new SIM card. And all they need to do then is use your password and email combination to get into your account and have a text message sent to your phone. And so be very, very careful with how you configure your two-factor authentication. It is ideal that you use an app instead of a text message response. And with that app, you could also use a security key. There are USB keys available that you can plug in as well. If you do that one thing correctly, just do that one thing. This is the one thing. Promise me, if you do one thing for your small business security, that's the most important thing that you can do. It's going to save you a lot of headache and trouble with compromised accounts. If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius. Or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.